So hi everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's session, we'll be talking about the PIB news from 22nd to 24th of April 2023. Okay, so yeah, without any delay, let's start with the class. And there are some very important questions today. There are some very important news today. So pay attention to all the questions. Question number one. Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region will be organizing the first Northeast Global Investor Summit in August 2023 in New Delhi. Which of the following organization is the investment facilitation partner of this team of this summit? Now, theek hai, this will be organized in the month of August 2023. But why we are discussing it today? That is the question. Because it is in news, because some interaction, some round table interaction was conducted by the Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region with trade association or bilateral chambers for preparation of the upcoming Northeast Global Investor Summit. ठीक है, इसलिए ये news में है. And as the question says that this summit will take place in the month of August 2023 in New Delhi, and it will be of course organized by the Ministry of Development of Northeastern Region. And there will be two different partners in this summit. Number one is the investment facilitation partner, which will be Invest India. And industry partner will be FICCI, Federation of Chamber of Commerce and Industry. Right? FICCI will be the industry partner, while Invest India will be the investment facilitation partner. Now, can you tell me who is the chairperson of FICCI? Who is the president of FICCI? Write down in the comment section. President of FICCI ka naam batana hai. And this sector, this summit will focus on these sectors, which you don't have to remember. Obviously, you don't have to remember all the sectors. This is just for the basic thing that actually on which sector this summit will focus, will be focused. And yeah, so these are the sectors jiske upar ye focus kare. All right. So that is all. And jab ye summit hogi in the month of August 2023, we'll discuss about this summit in detail. Theek hai ji? So the question is about the investment facilitation partner, and that will be Invest India. Option C is the correct answer. Now, please don't get confused between Invest India and FICCI. Invest India will be the investment facilitation partner, while FICCI will be the industry partner. All right. Question number two. The leaders meeting of Major Economies Forum on Energy and Climate Change has been convened virtually by United States of America. When was this Major Economies Forum on Energy and Climate Change launched? So remember guys, it was launched in the year 2019 by USA only, by the then President Barack Obama, right? So unhone isko launch kiya tha, and currently iski meeting hui thi virtually, and it was also conducted by USA, and that is why it is in news. So the leaders meeting of Major Economies Forum on Energy and Climate Change has been convened virtually by United States of America. And as I told you, this forum was established in the year 2009 by the then US President Barack Obama. And as the name says, it is a group, it is a network of those countries, of basically the emitting countries, of the major emitting countries, chahe wo developed ho ya under ya fir developing ho. And this is basically a discussion forum where all the leaders come together to discuss how we can cut down the emissions and how we can cut down the negative impacts on the climate change. All right. And these are the member countries of this forum, which you don't have to remember at all. But remember, India is a member of this. China is also a member of this. Pakistan is not there. Right? Pakistan is not the member of this forum. Okay? All right. So that is all. And when was this launched? So it was launched in the year 2009. And that's why option B is the correct answer. Question number three. Question number three says, what is the name of the monitoring center or platform launched at National Mission for Clean Ganga office in New Delhi for planning and monitoring of projects, river water quality, etc. through various online dashboards? So remember, very recently a meeting, the Empower Task Force meeting, the Empower Task Force meeting of National Mission on Clean Ganga took place, and it was headed by Union Minister of Jal Shakti. And who is the minister? Gajendra Singh Shekhawat is the Union Minister of Jal Shakti, right? And of course, this task force met to review the progress of various components under the Namami Gange program, right? And during this meeting, two initiatives were launched. Number one, Prayag Center, monitoring center or platform, which is Prayag Center, has been launched at the National Mission for Clean Ganga office at New Delhi, right? Now, what is this Prayag? Platform for real-time analysis of Yamuna, Ganga and their tributaries. Right? What is Prayag? Platform for real-time analysis for Yamuna, Ganga and its tributaries. Okay? So, that is the full form of Prayag. Right? And remember, Prayag is a real-time monitoring center and it provides information for planning, monitoring of projects, river water quality, etc. through various online dashboards. Right? Online dashboards such as Ganga Tarang Portal, Jajmau Plant, through online drone data. So basically there are various online dashboards, right? Through all those dashboards, this Prayag center, this Prayag platform will provide a real-time monitoring platform for planning and monitoring of all the projects. Okay? And the other initiative which was launched, the other thing which was launched was a comic series, Chacha Chaudhary ke saath Ganga ki baat. And we all know Chacha Chaudhary, who is a comic character, right? He, Chacha Chaudhary is the brand ambassador of Namami Gange program. Okay? So that is all about it. And what is that platform which has been launched? Prayag. Option A is the correct answer. Question number 4 pe aa jate hain. Atal Innovation Mission of Niti Aayog in partnership with which United Nations organization has launched a white paper to make India a global leader in agri-tech innovation and expand these innovations to the least developed countries in Asia and Africa. ठीक है, तो कौन सी United Nations agency के साथ Atal Innovation Mission ने MOU या agreement sign किया है? So remember, this organization guys is United Nations Capital Development Fund. It is United Nations Capital Development Fund with which Atal Innovation Mission has launched a white paper. Now this white paper, through this white paper, both these organizations, Atal Innovation Mission through Niti Aayog and United Nations Capital Development Fund, will collaborate to make India a global leader in agri-tech innovation and to transfer all those innovation in the developing countries in Asia and Africa. Right? That is the objective of this white paper. And through this, you know, through this, what will happen? जो इंडिया है उसके सामने जो भी चैलेंजेस है इन द एरिया ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर और एग्रीटेक, उन चैलेंजेस के ऊपर काम किया जाएगा. सो इट ऑफर्स एक्शनेबल स्टेप्स टू ओवरकम चैलेंजेस फेस्ड बाय एग्रीटेक स्टार्टअप्स एंड फैसिलिटेट देयर ग्रोथ एट नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल लेवल्स. इट सजेस्ट रिकमेंडेशंस टू टैकल चैलेंजेस इन एग्रीकल्चर सेक्टर एंड हाउ वी कैन प्रमोट सस्टेनेबल प्रैक्टिसेस टू मेक आवर एग्रीकल्चर मोर सस्टेनेबल. राइट? And it focuses on addressing three key challenges in the agriculture sector in the country. And what are these three key challenges on which this white paper will be focused? So number one is the low productivity. Number two is the poor risk resilience. And number three is the inefficient supply chain management. So these are the three areas where we have to work a lot in the agriculture sector. And this white paper will do the same for us. Okay? So that is all about this news, and the correct answer therefore to this question guys is United Nations Capital Development Fund. Option D is the correct answer. Question number 5 pe aa jate hai. Identify incorrect statement about 100 food streets pilot project. Very very important question. I believe ye aapke exam mein hona chahiye, ya to phase 1 mein ya fir phase 2 mein. So it is the first of all pilot project, and what is the project? फूड स्ट्रीट्स प्रोजेक्ट. फूड स्ट्रीट्स प्रोजेक्ट, इससे आपको क्या चमकता है? पराठे वाली गली टाइप की कोई चीज होगी. यस yes, बिल्कुल वही है. सो फूड स्ट्रीट्स को इसमें प्रमोट करा जाएगा इस प्रोजेक्ट के अंदर. सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर इन कोलैबोरेशन विद मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. दिस मिनिस्ट्री हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर इज हेडेड बाय मनसुख मंडाविया एंड हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स इज हेडेड बाय मिस्टर हरदीप सिंह पुरी. ऑलराइट, सो द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हेल्थ एंड फैमिली वेलफेयर इन कोलैबोरेशन विद हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स has requested all the states and UTs to develop 100 food streets in 100 districts across the country. 100 district mein 100 food streets banaye jayenge, and this will be done to create an example for other such streets to come up across the country for ensuring hygiene and safe food practices. So basically the overall objective is the promotion of hygiene, safe food and nutritious food practices. All right, that is the major objective of the food streets. To encourage safe and healthy food practices among businesses and community members and to reduce foodborne illnesses and improve the overall health outcomes, right? It will be implemented through National Health Mission in convergence with the Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. So, ye to main pehle se hi samajh mein aa gaya tha when jab humne padha tha that it has been launched by Ministry of Health and Family Welfare in collaboration with Ministry of Housing and Urban Affairs. Theek hai? And technical support, remember, will be provided by FSSAI, Food Safety and Standards Authority of India. The financial assistance per food street will be rupees 1 crore, right? 1 crore per food street will be provided, and this will be provided in the form of this 60-40 and 90-10 ratio. 60-40 will, abhi inhone bataya nahi waise kya hoga 60-40 hoga general states ka, and 90-10 must be of the northeastern hilly states and Himalayan states. Theek hai, to wahi hai. The assistance will be provided under NHM in the ratio of 60-40 or 90-10 with condition that standard branding of these food streets will be done as per the FSSAI standards. Alright, yeh 60-40-90-10, it must be that only. 60-40 is for general states, right? And 90-10 is for northeastern states, Himalayan states, right? Or या यही होते हैं जनरली, ठीक है? और इसके अलावा जो बच गए वो इसके अंदर आ जाते हैं. एंड यूटी भी हो सकते हैं इसके अंदर, यूटीज भी हो सकते हैं 90-10 वालों, ठीक है? सो या दैट इज ऑल अबाउट इट. सो लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट निकाल लेते हैं. इट विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड थ्रू एनएचएम इन कन्वर्जेंस विद द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ हाउसिंग एंड अर्बन अफेयर्स. बिल्कुल सही बात है, नो प्रॉब्लम विद दिस. एफएसएसएआई विल बी प्रोवाइडिंग द टेक्निकल सपोर्ट फॉर इट, ये भी ठीक है, नो प्रॉब्लम. Financial assistance to states or UTs under it will be in the form of rupees 5 crore per food street. No, it will not be 5 crores. We have just discussed. It will be how much? 1 crore. Rupees 1 crore per food street. So this is the correct answer, guys, to this question, because this is the incorrect statement. Right? So option C is the correct answer. Question number 6. Very, very important. The very first census of water bodies. So, मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति ने कंडक्ट किया है द वेरी फर्स्ट सेंसस ऑफ वाटर बॉडी. सो यू नीड टू आइडेंटिफाई विच स्टेटमेंट, विच ऑफ दी स्टेटमेंट्स आर करेक्ट, राइट? सो इसकी बात कर लेते हैं सेंसस की, देन वी विल कम टू द क्वेश्चन. सो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ जल शक्ति हैज लॉन्च द फर्स्ट एडिशन ऑफ सेंसस ऑफ वाटर बॉडीज, एंड दैट इज वाई दिस न्यूज इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर यू गाइज. इन कन्वर्जेंस विद द 6th माइनर इरीगेशन सेंसस अंडर सेंट्रली स्पॉन्सर्ड स्कीम इरीगेशन सेंसस, राइट? So, अब इसके जो जो मेजर हाईलाइट्स है उसके बारे में बात कर लेते. सो देर आर 24,24,540 वॉटर बॉडीज विच हैव बीन इन्यूमरेटेड इन दिस वॉटर सेंसस, एंड आउट ऑफ दिस नंबर ऑफ वॉटर बॉडीज 97.1% आर इन द रूरल एरियाज, वाइल इन अर्बन एरियाज वी हैव ओनली 2.9% ऑफ द टोटल वॉटर बॉडीज, राइट? 97.1% and 2.9%. So you can see the ratio. 59.5% of the water bodies are ponds. So major water bodies are ponds. More approximately 60%. Followed by tanks, which consist of 15.7% of the overall water bodies. Reservoirs 12.1%. Water conservation schemes, percolation tanks and check dams 9.3%. Lakes 0.9% and others 2.5%. So you should remember the maximum ponds 59.5%, right? Other than this, this slide is very, very important. मुझे लगता है कि अगर water census में से question आया तो इसी में से आएगा. West Bengal has the highest number of ponds and reservoirs in the country. Andhra Pradesh has the highest number of tanks in the country. Tamil Nadu has the highest number of lakes in the country, and Maharashtra is the leading state for water conservation scheme, which means the maximum and the most effective water conservation schemes are being implemented by the state of Maharashtra. All right. Now, 55.2% of water bodies are owned in the country by the private entities, whereas 44.8% of water bodies are in the domain of public ownership. ठीक है? 78% water bodies are man-made. Man-made 78% है, और 22% क्या है? Natural water bodies है, ठीक है? Now, इसके बाद ये वाली जो चीज़ें, ये भी काफी important है. Top 5 states in terms of number of water bodies. सबसे ज़्यादा water bodies कहाँ पे है? West Bengal में, followed by UP, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and Assam. So, if you cannot remember the top 5s, at least remember the top 3s. Because RBI में आजकल पूछ लेते हैं यार, ठीक है ना? तो West Bengal is the top, followed by Uttar Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and Assam. Right, and they constitute, these 5 states constitute 63% of the total water bodies in the country. Okay, now top 5 states in the number of water bodies in urban areas. Okay, अर्बन एरियाज में सबसे ज्यादा वाटर बॉडीज कौन से स्टेट में है? अगेन वेस्ट बंगाल, फॉलोड बाय तमिलनाडु, केरला, यूपी एंड त्रिपुरा, राइट? नाउ व्हाट अबाउट रूरल एरियाज? अगेन इट इज वेस्ट बंगाल विच इज एट नंबर वन, फॉलोड बाय उत्तर प्रदेश, आंध्र प्रदेश, उड़ीसा एंड असम, राइट? And which are the top 5 states which lead in the private owned water bodies? So these are again West Bengal. West Bengal is at the top. Assam, Andhra Pradesh, Odisha and Jharkhand. Right? Now what about the top 5 states? Achha, pehle ye padh lo. Dekho, ek cheez hai jo ki important hai. Out of all in use water bodies. Aisi water bodies jo use mein hai. Major water bodies are being used in pisciculture. पिस्सीकल्चर में सबसे ज्यादा यूज होती है भाई, सबसे ज्यादा वाटर बॉडी का यूज हो रही है हमारी पिस्सीकल्चर में, और ये वाटर बॉडीज कौन सी है जो कि इन यूज है, राइट? फॉलोड बाय इरिगेशन, देन ग्राउंड वाटर रिचार्ज एंड डोमेस्टिक और ड्रिंकिंग पर्पस, ऑलराइट? एंड टॉप 5 स्टेट्स वेयर मेजर यूज ऑफ वाटर बॉडीज इज इन पिस्सीकल्चर, अगेन नंबर 1 पे वेस्ट बंगाल है हमारे पास, असम, उड़ीसा, उत्तर प्रदेश एंड आंध्र प्रदेश. एंड टॉप 5 स्टेट्स वेयर वाटर बॉडीज जहां पे पानी ज्यादातर यूज होता है इरिगेशन के लिए, उसमें झारखंड है. तो जितनी भी कैटेगरीज हमने पढ़ी उसमें केवल एक कैटेगरी में झारखंड नंबर 1 पे, बाकी सब में वेस्ट बंगाल. तो एटलीस्ट इतना तो आपको याद रहेगा कि वेस्ट बंगाल सारी कैटेगरीज में नंबर 1 पे है. अ मेजर प्रपोर्शन ऑफ वॉटर बॉडीज दैट इज 83.7% आर इन यूज, बाकी जो 16.3% बच गई दीज आर नॉट इन यूज बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस रीजन लाइक ड्रॉट, राइट? लाइक ड्रॉट हो गया, कंस्ट्रक्शन हो गया, सिल्टेशन हो गया, डिस्ट्रॉयड बियॉन्ड रिपेयर, इस तरीके के रीजंस की वजह से वो यूज में नहीं है, ठीक है? सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द वाटर सेंसेस गाइस, दिस इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. तो नाउ लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. 24,24,540 ये वाला नंबर तो याद रख लेना यार, ठीक है? 24,24,540, ठीक है? 24,24,540 इज द नंबर. 24,24,540 अगर हिंदी में करना चाहते हो तो. Have been enumerated in the country, ये बात बिल्कुल सही है, there is no problem in it. West Bengal has highest number of water bodies, yes, बिल्कुल सही बात है. उत्तर प्रदेश has highest number of water bodies in urban areas, नहीं, West Bengal था ये. West Bengal has highest number of water bodies in urban areas, followed by, ये बिल्कुल सही है. Out of all in use water bodies, major water bodies are being used up in irrigation, no. आउट ऑफ ऑल इन यूज वाटर बॉडी सबसे ज्यादा पानी कहां पे यूज होता है? सबसे ज्यादा वाटर बॉडीज किसके लिए यूज होती है? पिस्सीकल्चर के लिए, ठीक है? सो 3 and 5 आर इनकरेक्ट एंड 1, 2, 4 आर करेक्ट, विच मीन्स ऑप्शन सी विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन सी इज द करेक्ट आंसर गाइज. ओके, लेट्स मूव अहेड टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 7, विच इज अगेन अ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट न्यूज एंड वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन अबाउट द 5th एडिशन ऑफ उड़ान, उड़े देश का आम नागरिक रीजनल कनेक्टिविटी स्कीम. It was launched by the Ministry of Civil Aviation with an objective to provide what? To provide affordable air travel to the common man, to the mango people of the country. ठीक है जी? So, Udaan 5th edition has been launched and this 5th edition is focused on 2 categories of airlines or aircrafts, you can say. Category 2, 20 to 80 seats and category 3, more than 80 seats. Now, the 20 to 80 seats means 20 to 80 seats will be reserved for the Udaan beneficiary. Category 3 aircraft will be those where more than 80 seats will be reserved for Udaan beneficiary. Okay? It has this 5th edition has waived off the earlier stage length cap of 600 kilometers. So earlier there was a cap, length cap 600 kilometer. It has been removed now, and thus now there is no restriction on the distance between the origin and the destination. Jahan marji jao, jitna marji destination cover karo, no problem. It has capped the VGF, the viability gap funding, at 600 km stage length for both priority and non-priority areas. Earlier, this viability gap funding was capped at 500 km. So this has also been increased by 100 km. Okay? Now what is viability gap funding? So whenever there is a shortage of funds, let's say Ministry of Civil Aviation is providing rupees 100 to, let's say, any particular ticket. राइट, लेकिन टिकट आ रही है 110 रुपए की, तो ये 10 रुपए एक्स्ट्रा कहां से आएंगे? फ्रॉम वेयर? दिस एक्स्ट्रा 10 रुपी विल कम. सो दिस एक्स्ट्रा 10 रुपी विल कम फ्रॉम वायबिलिटी गैप फंडिंग. ठीक है? नाउ इट ऑफर्स नो प्रीडिटरमाइंड रूट्स. सो देर आर नो प्रीडिटरमाइंड रूट्स, राइट? एंड ओनली रूट्स एंड विल ओनली कंसिडर नेटवर्क एंड इंडिविजुअल रूट प्रपोज्ड बाय द एयरलाइंस. ठीक है? कोई प्रीडिटरमाइंड रूट इसमें नहीं होगा. Next, it will not about same route to a single airline more than once, whether in different networks or in the same network. एक ही एयरलाइन को सेम रूट बार बार नहीं मिलेगा, ठीक है? Airlines will be required to commence operation within 4 months of the award of the route. Earlier, this deadline was 6 months, ठीक है? And finally, it includes the list of airports that are ready for operation or soon will be ready for operations to facilitate the quick operationalization of routes. ठीक है, ये last वाला point इतना important नहीं है, बाकी जो 3-4 points हमने जो भी पढ़े, all are important. ठीक है जी? So these are the some major features of Udaan 5.0 and let's identify the incorrect statement. It focuses on category 2 and category 3 seats. Category 3 more than 80 seats, बिल्कुल सही है. It has waived off earlier stage length cap of 600 km, ये भी ठीक है. It has capped viability gap funding at 500 km stage length. No, earlier it was 500 km, now it has been increased to 600 km. This statement is incorrect. It only offers predetermined routes. No, there are no predetermined routes. And it will award same route to a single airline more than once. ये भी बात गलत है. तो केवल दो ही सही हुए इसमें तो. बट हमें क्या निकालना है? इनकरेक्ट निकालना है. 3, 4 and 5 should be the correct answer, which is not in the option. तो कुछ गलती हो गई क्या? Okay, yes, this one is correct. It will not award same route to a single airline more than once. Yes. So 1, 2 and 5, वो भी नहीं option में. क्या करना है हमें? इनकरेक्ट निकालना है. तो 3 and 4 होना चाहिए ऑप्शन में. हाँ है, यस, 3 and 4 ओनली इज द करेक्ट आंसर, ऑप्शन ई. ठीक है, 3 and 4 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. एंड नाउ गाइस, लेट्स मूव अहेड टू द क्वेश्चंस इन शॉर्ट व्हिच डू नॉट नीड मच एक्सप्लेनेशन. बट याद रखना कि इनकी भी उतनी ही इंपॉर्टेंस है. बट बिफोर दैट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू हैव द पीडीएफ ऑफ दिस सेशन, यू कैन ज्वाइन द टेलीग्राम चैनल. द लिंक इज प्रोवाइडेड इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन. क्वेश्चन नंबर 8. Which of the following ministry has organized the Global Buddhist Summit in New Delhi under the theme Responses to Contemporary Challenges, Philosophy to Praxis? Now, of course, this ministry, kya lagta hai aapko, kaun si ministry hogi ye? Can you answer this question logically? Yes, of course, I can answer this question logically. It must be the Ministry of Culture headed by G. Kishan Reddy. And yes, that is the correct answer, option C. Question number 9. During the ongoing SCO Council of Heads of States, Presidency of India, Shanghai Cooperation Organization aims at advancing the theme of secure, during which SCO summit this theme was articulated by PM Modi. कौन से summit में secure theme के बारे में बात हुई थी, secure theme को articulate किया गया था, right? So this was Qingdao summit of 2018 and of course Qingdao is a city of China. Option E is the correct answer. Question number 10. Which of the following two northeastern states recently have signed historic agreement to settle the long pending border dispute between them? Right. However, this question is not important for economic and social issue, but theek hai, thoda sa kabhi kabhi knowledge ke liye bhi padh lena chahiye. So Assam and Arunachal are the two states and that's why the correct answer is option C, 1 and 4 only. Question number 11. Which search web portal has been developed by National Archives of India to make its rich treasure of archival records available to scholars and users? So this is a very, very important question. National Archive of India has developed a web portal which is known as Abhilekh Patal. Right, what is the name? Abhilekh Patal is the correct answer, is the name of that web portal launched by National Archive of India. Question number 12. In which northeastern state has central government recently inaugurated 254 4G mobile towers to provide mobile and internet connectivity? And इसके बारे में इसलिए पढ़ रहे हैं because 254 is a big number, so इसलिए एग्जाम में पूछा जा सकता है. The state in question is Arunachal Pradesh. Option E is the correct answer. Which PSU has become first in the country to take initiative for setting up a dedicated 5G network with the help of TCIL, which is Telecommunications Consultants India Limited. ठीक है? So which PSU is this? So that's SAIL, Steel Authority of India Limited. And option D is the correct answer. Question number 14. With which oil sector PSU has CSIR signed an umbrella MOU to pursue technological partnership in select domains across the energy value chain? Remember, this oil sector PSU is Oil India Limited. Oil. इन शॉर्ट इट इज ऑयल ओनली, ऑयल पीएसयू का नाम ही ऑयल है, राइट। सो ऑयल इंडिया लिमिटेड ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 15, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन, विच स्टेट इज द लार्जेस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ मिलेट इन इंडिया, विच हैज कॉन्ट्रीब्यूटेड 16% शेयर इन द टोटल मिलेट प्रोडक्शन ऑफ द कंट्री इन 2020-2021। वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट इज राजस्थान, ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर। And the last question for today, which of the following is not one of the five key pillars for development under Sagarmala program? So, port modernization, port connectivity, port-led industrialization, coastal shipping and inland water transport, and coastal community development. Coastal community development are the five pillars. Are the five pillars of this Sagarmala program. This is not one of the five pillars and option D is the correct answer. Alright guys, so that is all for today's class. I hope all the questions and their explanations are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. And I will see you in the next class on Friday. Till then, keep studying and keep studying hard. Goodbye, take care and God bless.